24 equals a 64 discharge superheat. Most VRF manufacturers are looking anywhere from a 27 to a 72 degree range discharge superheat. If we're below that, you're compressing liquid. Not 100%, but a version of a mixture, if you will. If you're above that, you're not getting enough vapor back, or you don't have enough oil lubricating your compressor. Let's talk about high discharge superheat, low discharge superheat. So, as everybody else has covered, which I'm going to cover again pretty quickly, examples of high discharge superheat. Why do I have a high discharge superheat? I'm on a job, I've got my service checker, my service device, my VRF equipment, and I see high discharge superheat right at the get-go. The cause of high discharge superheat is a shortage of refrigerant. Remember, we're relying on a medium, right? You guys are breathing a refrigerant, remember? Drinking a refrigerant, Ty covered that. For shortage of refrigerant to a compressor, we're talking about refrigerant being the medium. A lack of refrigerant flowing to the compressor, a lack of supply of vapor, right? High suction superheat getting to the compressor will give you the sign of high discharge superheat. If it's not getting enough to the compressor, it will show high discharge superheat on the lead income side of the compressor. Other signs of high discharge superheat, oil shortage within the compressor. If the system is undercharged or overcharged, or maybe possibly not getting all the oil back to the compressor. So if I have a 20 degree superheat,